Yeah. Gone on you with the pick and roll. Younger Flame, he in sicko mode.
This here with all the ice on in the booth. At the gate outside, when they pull up, they get me loose. Yeah, jump out, boys. That's Nike boys. I've been out.
Good morning, STM. I'm Carlin Sakani Matthews.
And I'm Jackson Coolville. Welcome to our first episode of 2019.
We're super excited to kick off another great year of broadcasting.
We have an awesome episode for you today with three commercials, as well as a closer look at our beloved bowling team.
Special shout out to our producer, Emily Stevenson, for creating our amazing limited edition intro.
Before CougarCast goes sicko mode, please stand for prayer and pledge.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. Eternal Father, I offer you the most precious blood of thy divine Son, Jesus, in union with the masses said throughout the world today, for all the holy souls in purgatory, for sinners everywhere, for sinners in the universal church, for those in my own home and in my family. Amen. St. Thomas More, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Can you believe that it's been 5 weeks since our last show?
We missed out on so much.
Like the whole government shutdown thing. That was crazy.
I know. Can you believe it's still going on?
Wait, it is?
Absolutely. For those that don't remember, President Trump called for a partial federal government shutdown on December 22nd of last year due to disputes in Congress over spending on the Mexican border wall.
For a frame of reference, the previous length for the longest shutdown was 21 days during President Clinton's first term. Today marks 28 days for President Trump.
Please keep everyone with government jobs that were affected by the shutdown in your prayers, as it's been nearly a whole month without pay for them.
We also ask that you keep some of our very own STM students in your prayers as they march today in the 46th annual March for Life against abortion at our nation's capital.
Cougars for Life is sponsoring Soup and Silence today at both lunches in remembrance of those victims of abortion.
In other news, I saw that Netflix raised their subscription prices from $11 to $13 worldwide.
Yeah, that's crazy, but I'm still going to use Netflix. Did you see that Missy Elliott was inducted as the first woman rapper into the Songwriters Hall of Fame?
No way, that's so cool.
Agreed. Also, did you happen to see the YouTube Rewind?
I did. Just like with The Egg, the internet came together to make sure that last year's Rewind topped Justin Bieber's Baby as the number one worst video ever.
Wait, The Egg?
Yeah.
What do you mean, The Egg?
What, you didn't know? This picture of an egg became the most liked picture on Instagram. It's sitting at 48 million likes currently.
Wow, that's...
Beautiful? I agree. You know what else is beautiful?
The sport of bowling?
What?
You know, bowling, America's favorite pastime.
Are you sure about that?
Definitely. Nick Musso provided an in-depth look at our own bowling team. I'm sure it'll convince you.
I can't wait.
For most, bowling is just a recreational sport, a game to be played at birthday parties and get-togethers. But for others, it's a competition. That's why STM has their very own bowling team. We interviewed Coach John Dupuy and some of the bowlers on the team to see what bowling is really all about.
Bowling is taken as a serious sport. We're an LHSAA sanctioned sport. We have state championships for individuals and teams, boys and girls, just like we have state champions in football, volleyball, golf, swim. And we encourage the camaraderie, also the sportsmanship, as you'd expect for a good Christian athlete.
Bowling is fun.
Our season starts off on January the 14th, and we encourage everybody to come out and watch the Cougars bowl. We bowl on Mondays at Lafayette Lanes, and Wednesdays at Lafayette Lanes or Acadian Lanes, but just keep up with Cougar Cats for where we're going to be bowling each week.
Wow, that really makes me want to join bowling.
Man, our bowling team's really on a roll.
You know who else is on a roll? Our Sparklers. They only have 15 days left until they go to Nationals.
The Sparklers will be performing their national palm and jazz routines this Saturday at 2 p.m. in the Cougar Dome before leaving for Orlando.
Please come out and support these hardworking girls.
Our technology department is also hard at work as they are preparing for a conference on campus next Wednesday.
STM will be hosting over 80 teachers from across the state in the biannual Louisiana Educational Technology Consortium.
So if you see any guests on our campus, be sure to give them a warm welcome.
That evening, we will be hosting a technology showcase for all of you to attend.
If you have any interest in our STEM electives on campus, feel free to check it out. Let's learn more about it with this brief commercial break.
All students in grades K through 12 are invited to the Technology Showcase Wednesday, January 23rd from 4 to 7 p.m. at STM. Students, parents, and friends will enjoy STEM-based activities for middle schools, high schools, and upper education. Get ready for mind-blowing hands-on activities and great door prizes. Hey, I heard that you're presenting at the Tech Showcase.
I sure am, but you're going to have to wait. You're going to have to attend to see what Nick and I are working on.
And there's free food. All the more reason to come.
Attention all junior and senior campus ministers, your Kairos forms are due today.
And freshman and sophomore campus ministers, the Crossroads Retreat is approaching quickly. Make sure to sign up.
Speaking of deadlines, college applications should definitely have been completed by now.
There's still time to get everything put together, but you'd better hurry.
UL applications are due January 31st in order to be eligible for scholarships.
The same goes for LSU. Don't forget it's not too late to improve your ACT score for TOPS eligibility. The next ACT will be in April.
Be smart and submit your applications on time.
This next commercial will reveal your tech knowledge.
Let's check out our tech tip.
Do your speakers on your laptop not work anymore? Well, you should have looked at the tweet from Help Desk, but we'll show you here too. To start off, click the small caret at the bottom of your taskbar. Click on the speaker button where you'd typically adjust the volume of your computer. On top of the volume bar, there should be this one name that says projector. Click the caret button to the right of that. Then select Speakers, Realtek High Definition Audio, and now you're all set. You're welcome.
Great. Now I only have to be yelled at by Miss Robin during first hour.
Yay! We want everyone to be in a good mood for next week.
What's next week?
How do you not know what next week is? It's Cougar Court!
Oh, that's right. For those of you who don't know, Cougar Court is like homecoming week, but for basketball.
Let's toss it to Tyler, who has the scoop on all the dress days and lunch games that are planned.
Road work ahead?
Yeah, I sure hope it does.
Good morning, Cougars. I'm Annie Pryor, here to give you the inside scoop on all STM athletics. Let's start with what's in store for the basketball and soccer teams. First, the Lady Cougar and boys basketball team will have home games tonight versus Turlings. The girls play at 6:30 and the boys play at 7:45. A reminder to all faculty that tonight is faculty night, so come out and show your support. There will be door prizes throughout the night. Also, boys soccer team is at Karen Crow High School tonight at 7:30. The boys are 2-0 in district play so far. Good luck to everyone competing today. Tomorrow, track and field will have an indoor meet at Louisiana State University in Baton Rouge. Wish the track team good luck as they compete in the high school qualifier meet. In other news, girls soccer will be competing tomorrow against Mount Carmel Academy at home at 3 p.m. This will be senior day, so let's support our 8 senior girls. At the moment, their record is 13-2-1, which makes them undefeated in district. Great job, ladies. The last announcement I have for you today is the cheer squad and their performance of their national routines in the gym at 5 p.m. on Monday. What a better way to start off our Cougar Court Week and get into school spirit. That's all I have for you today for sports. Now on to weather.
Hey there and good morning, Cougars. I'm Nick Musso for your weekend weather report. Today, we're going to have a 20% chance of rain, high of 70, and a low of 62. Tomorrow, it's going to be cold and wet with an 80% chance of rain, high of 66 and a low of 35. That means the roads might freeze over, so be careful. And on Sunday, it's going to be even colder with a high of 51 and a low of 32. Boy, that's chilly, Cougars. And it's going to have a 0% chance of rain. That's all I got for your weekend weather report. Let's move on back to our anchors.
We want to give a special shout out to the birthdays for this weekend. Today's birthdays include Aaron Logan, Caroline McDaniel, Ty McNemev, Bryce Bouillon, and Miss Heidi.
And Saturday birthdays are Carson Beggy, Megan Ruley, and Georgina Marinez.
And then on Sunday, we have Aiden Babineau, Kennedy Keita, Sydney Hemphill, Reese DuPont, and James Stonecipher.
Happy birthday to all these people. Don't forget that Cougar Coffee is selling coffee and snacks every morning before school. All proceeds go to fund the 4th annual technology mission trip in Haiti.
Get ready for next week because we're going full 90s.
We hope to see you guys dressed up in all the dress days next week.
Have a great 3-day weekend, everyone. I'm Jackson Corville.
And I'm Carlin Sakani Matthews.
See you next week.